So good morning, first year BSc statistics class 9 unit 1. Today we start with some new concept and PPTs. So in the previous classes we may continue various topics. So in right now we are in unit 1, that is descriptive introduction to descriptive statistics. So we complete the concepts like primary and secondary data, classification of data, various types of data, measures of central tendencies, means arithmetic mean, median, mode, geometric mean and harmonic mean with some examples, absolute and relative measures of dispersion, measures of dispersion and measures of variance, both we completed. Measures of dispersions and measures of variances, like ranges, calculating ranges, mean deviation, standard deviations, sample deviation, population deviations, various variance calculations with applications. Applications means examples. Importance of movements. Importance of movements. Today we discuss the about importance of movements, central and non-central movements, their interrelationships, Shepard's correction for movements for group data, measures of skewness based on quartiles and movements, kurtosis based on movements with real life examples, and these are the reference and additional books for BSc first year statistics. So you have to buy all these books, any of one of the book, not all. So I will post them into your group also. So we start with PPT. So today we discuss about movements of data, various types of movements and different types of formulas. We are right now in unit 1 of statistics 1 syllabus. So different types of movements, what is a movement, definition, explanation, examples. So today's objectives of the PPT is movement about mean, that is central movements. Why? Because mean is existed the center point of the data. So today we start with a problem finding standard deviation for a group of data, or a standard deviation, how to find standard deviation of a given sample data. So what is the formula for standard deviation? S is equals to square root of sigma x minus x bar whole square into f by n minus 1, where n is equals to sigma f is the number of entries or number of data items, number of items in the data set, where n is equals to number of items, that is equal to sigma f is the number of items in the data set, and x is the data value or the midpoint of the interval. So what is the formula for finding standard deviation? S is equals to square root of sigma x minus x bar into f by n minus 1. So what is the formula for standard deviation? Is equals to square root of sigma x minus x bar, x minus x bar whole square into f by n minus 1, where x is the data item, f is the frequency, and x bar is the mean, n is the number of items. So problem is, the following frequency distribution represents the ages of 30 students in a statistical class. The mean age of the student is 30.3 years. Find the standard deviation of the frequency distribution. So this is the problem. So this is the table and solution. So class interval is 18 to 25, 26 to 33, 34 to 41, 42 to 49, 50 to 57. And frequency f is equals to 13, 8, 4, 3, 2. And capital X. What is capital X? Capital X is the mean of the class. Capital X is the mean of the class variable. That is, for class 18 to 25, the median is, at the average is 18 plus 25 by 2, that is 21.5. So next is, we have to find out x minus x bar. What is x bar? So the problem is standard deviation, finding standard deviation for a simple data item, for a sample data item or a simple data item. So what is x? X is the data item or the average of the class item, x bar is the mean. So in the next table, in the next column, we have to find out x minus x bar. Next is x minus x bar whole square. We have to find out x minus x bar whole square. And in the last column, we have to multiply frequency and x minus x bar whole square. So x minus x bar whole square into f. And sigma f is called as total sum of the values of the frequency data items, that is small n. So small n is equals to 30. Here there are two terms, two terminologies are used. Small n means sigma f, that is the sum of all the frequencies, that is 30. Capital N means number of items in the data set. And sigma x minus x bar whole square into f means sum of all the values of the classes for x minus x bar whole square by f, that is 2988.80. So the standard formula for standard deviation, what is the formula for sample standard deviation, is s is equals to square root of sigma x minus x bar whole square into f by n minus n, where n is the sum of the frequencies. So here square root of 2988.8 by 29, that is square root of 103.06, that is 10.2. So the standard deviation of the ages is 10.2 years. And you have to buy a calculator also, new calculator, to do all these things. So we start new PPT. So this is another PPT to discuss about moments, moments of finding moments, different types of moments, how to find various moments in the statistical data, what are the types like that. So today's PPT is about, describe about moments about mean. It is called as central moment. What is central moment means? We are calculating the moments towards mean, means center point of the data, so that it is called as central moments. Second one is moments about any arbitrary origin. Third one is moments about zero, and fourth one is related Excel. So we start with the definition of the moments and the different types of moments in statistics. So similarly, what is the relation between a central moment and moments about origin? So what are the central moment and what is moment about origin, and what are the differences between them? And moment ratios, skewness, skewness, what is skewness and what is kurtosis? What is skewness and what is kurtosis? We explain, discuss all these things today. So what are moments? A moment is a quantitative. A moment is a quantitative measure of the shape of a set of points. A moment is a quantitative measure of the shape of set of points. The first moment is called the mean, which describes the center of the distribution. The second moment is the variance, which describes the spread of the observations around the center. Other moments describe other aspects of a distribution, such as how the distribution is skewed from its mean or peaked. A moment designates the power to which deviations are raised before average them. So what is a moment? Moment is nothing but it is a quantitative item or a quantitative measurement. Quantitative means numeric measurement about the shape of the points or data items, means how the data items are formed, how the data items are formed in a shape. We will estimate them by using some quantitative methods. Why? Because all these are quantitative or numeric or number related data or concepts. So the first moment is called as mean. So mean means, which is generally, mean is existed at the central or center of the distribution of the data. Means generally the mean is we have to find the mean to locate or to find out the center of the numeric data. So that mean is the first moment. Mean is the first moment of the distribution. So the first moment of the data is called as mean. It describes the center of the data. Means we have to locate and find out and locate the center of the data to do calculations or some comparisons like that. So mean is the first moment. So second one is variance. Second moment is called as variance. So first moment is mean and the second moment is called as variance, which describes the spread of the observations around the center. So variance is nothing but it simply explains about the data around the data formed or data shaped in the form of around or in the form of some shape around the mean. Means generally the variance is measured or described about the spread of the data around the center or mean. So The second moment is variance. The second moment is variance. It simply explains about how the data items, data is spread around the mean or center point of the data. That is called as means shape, which shape the data is spread or in how the data is spread around. Means we measure the data items or measure the data, how it is formed along with or around the central point, means the mean. Third one is other moments describes other aspects of a distribution, such as how the distributed skewness and mean of a peak. So third moment is called as skewness, skewed. It is called as skewed and so we discuss one by one with some examples also. There are some formulas also to find out different types of moments. So we start with central moment, or it is also called as mean central moment or a mean moment. So in mean moment or a central moment, the deviations are taken from the mean. So the central moment or mean moments, the deviations, what is the deviation? Deviation means how far the data item is existed, means from which how far, means what is the distance between, what is the distance between the data item from the central point of the data or the central mean of the data. So in mean moment or a central moment, the deviations are taken from the means. Generally in moments we have to calculate the deviation is nothing but the distance between or distance from the center point of the data to the sample data. So first population moment about mean, first population, what is population? Population is nothing but a statistical term. So first population moment about mean, that is mu 1 is equals to sigma xi minus mu by capital N. So the first population moment or the first moment is called as mu 1, that is equal to sigma xi minus mu by capital N, where xi is the data item or sample data, mu is the mean of the data item, and capital N, generally capital N and small n, there are two variables are used, capital N and small n. Capital N is the total number of data items or sample data items, and small n is the sum of the frequencies. Small n is the sum of the frequencies, that is small n is equals to sigma f, where capital N is equals to number of terms or number of items in the data. So the first population moment, the first moment regarding mean is mu 1. It is generally represented with mu. Why? Because mu is represented for mean. Mu 1 is equal to sigma xi minus mu by capital N. So what is the formula? Sum of all the distances or data items from the central point are mean by total number, that is the average. So what is first data item or first mean value or population mean moment is mu 1 is equal to sigma xi minus mu by capital N. So the average of the distance for all the data items which is taken from the center point, that is mean value. Second population, next one is second population moment about mean, mu 2 is equal to sigma xi minus mu whole square by capital N. So the first moment formula is about mean is mu 1 is equal to sigma xi minus mu by capital N. Second population moment about mean is mu 2 is equal to sigma xi minus mu by sigma xi minus mu whole square by capital N, where capital N is the number of data items taken. And first sample moment first sample moment about mean m1 is equals to, so first population moment and first sample moment. Here there is a difference between these two. So population moment means we are going to take all the data items, and sample moment means we are taking only we are calculating the mean for a particular data item. Population moment means we are taking all the entire data set, and sample data moment means we are taking only one variable to calculate the moments. So first sample moments about mean m1 is equals to sigma xi minus x bar by small n. First sample moment about mean m1 is equals to sigma xi minus x bar by capital N. So what is x bar? X bar is nothing but it is a similarly, second sample moment about mean m2 is equals to sigma xi minus x bar whole square by small n. So generally, rth population moment about mean is equals to mu r is equals to sigma xi minus mu whole square by whole power r by capital N. Similarly, rth sample moment about mean mr is equals to sigma x1 xi minus x bar whole power r by capital N. So these are the different types of moments, like central moment, calculating central moments or mean moment for population data as well as sample data. So central or mean moments, so formula for group data, is rth population moment about mean is equals to mu r is equals to sigma f into xi minus mu whole power r by sigma f. Rth sample moment about mean is equals to mr is equals to sigma f into xi minus x bar whole power r by sigma f. So how to calculate central moments or mean moments? So example, calculate first four moments about the mean for the following set of examination marks. So x is equals to, here we are given some 10 to 12 values, 10 to 12 and 10 to 12 values like 45, 30 to 37, 46, 39, like that. Solution is, for solution move to, so how to find central moments, or mean moments? So calculate first four moments about mean for the following frequency distribution. So weight in grams and frequency. So weight in grams, that is class intervals 65, 84, 85, 104, and frequencies F. So total sum of the frequencies equals to 60. Next is, how to find moments about arbitrary origins? So if the deviations are taken, from some arbitrary number A called origin, then moments are called moments about arbitrary origin A. So for upgradation data and for group data, so we will continue in the next class.